We are done part one of taking off quantities of a swimming pool, whereby we looked at site clearance, excavation of top vegetable soil, and excavation of the pits. Now, on our part two, we are going to move straight to trenches for foundation, planking and strutting, concrete in foundation, base slab, and horizontal tanking, and then we do the reinforced slab. So we are going to look at the trench. This is our trench here. This part here is our trench where we have a depth of 200 millimeters. And for this trench, it's 1.0 meters wide, and it is going all along the swimming pool. So we need to find the measurements, that is external measurement. As you can see, the trench is projecting up to the projection. It's up to the projection here. So we need to find this external measurement up to the projection. That is what we had for the site clearance and excavation. And then we are going to find the mean girth, because it's along this entire swimming pool. It's along the entire swimming pool. And then after we've gotten the mean girth, we are going to find the width. The width is 1.0, and then the depth is 200 millimeters. Now let's start by getting the measurement. So whatever we had is external. We said we have internal, and then we add the walls. We have the 200 wall, the 20 vertical tanking, and then the 100 millimeters wall. That gives us 16840, and then we add the projection, which is 335. Maybe somebody's, this is the first time they are watching, so this is our projection here, 335 millimeters. And then that is what we add to get up to this point here. Now, once we add that, we have 13310 and 9310. Let's find the mini gut, that is, so we draw that one here. This is what we have. This is 13310 and this is 9310. Now we want to find the mini gut, that is perimeter along the center line. So it will be 2 into length plus width minus 4 the thickness. Our thickness is 1000. So if we tabulate that one here, we are going to get a mini gut of 41,240 millimeters. That is 41.24 meters. The strip is 1.0 meters wide and the depth is 200 millimeters. Now we bought concrete, that is in meter cubic. So we have the mini gut here. We have the width and we have the depth, and then we say excavate trenches to receive foundation concrete starting from strip level, depth not exceeding 1.5 but exceeding 3.0 meters. And then we backfill. And then we have an item here, an item. We do what we allow for necessary planking and strutting, and then upper sand dewatering. That is item, allow for necessary planking and strutting, upper sand dewatering. We go to concrete in the foundation. Concrete in that foundation, in that now strip foundation, this one here, where we have excavated the trench is where we are going to put our concrete. So we just take the same measurement for stripping, that is the mini gut, and then the width, and then the depth. So where we have done this stripping is where we are going to place our concrete, and then we say plain concrete in 1:3:6 in the foundation. Let's proceed to base slab. So on top of the trench, on top of that trench here, we have this base here, which is 150 millimeters long. So sorry, deep. You can, if you look at this trench on this section, it means it runs from out the projection up to the other side of projection. So we need the entire length. That is, our internal length was 12 meters, and then we add the walls, this wall here, that is 200 plus 20 plus 100 to get to external, and then we add 335. Remember, it's on both sides. So that is what we have here. That is 13310 and 9310. So our base is on the entire length and width, so that 13310 and 9.31, that is plain concrete in 1:3 in 150 millimeters thick bed.